More fallout from that jaw-dropping criminal complaint filed against Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich. The complaint alleges that he tried to sell the U.S. Senate seat vacated by President-elect Obama. On page 72, there's this assertion. In a recorded conversation on October 31st, 2008, Blagojevich described an earlier approach by an associate of Senate candidate number 5 as follows. We were approached pay to play. That, you know, he'd raise me 500 grand. An emissary came, then the other guy would raise a million more if I made him the Senate candidate, number 5, making him a senator. Our panel in Washington, James Carville, Democratic strategist, CNN political contributor. In here in Los Angeles, Larry Elder, the best-selling author and talk radio host. And in Washington, as well as Clarence Page, Chicago Tribune syndicated columnist and a member of the newspaper's editorial board, and they are also in the news. And Congressman Jackson, a staunch supporter of Obama, acknowledges he's candidate number 5. What do you make of this, James?
Well, he says that he's not a target, and he probably could be very well correct. I thought he didn't answer questions at the end of his press conference today. I don't think that's going to be able to stand. There's every reason to give him the benefit of the doubt as to what he says, but he's an elected official, and I think he's going to have to be more forthcoming in the future than he was to this morning.
Larry, what do you make of it?
Well, I think that James is right about the fact that he apparently is not a target, or at least the U.S. attorney said he was not a target. But I think the real question here is, would we be asking these kinds of questions of a Republican? What did he know and when did he know it? Barack Obama has said that he had no contact with the governor. Only days earlier, one of his top advisors said that he had. Rahm Emanuel, the incoming chief of staff, Larry, says that Barack Obama was a top campaign advisor to Blagojevich. And then just moments later, he said, Rahm Emanuel did, that he misspoke or that he was wrong. I think if this were a bunch of Republicans and the incoming president-elect was, say, somebody named George W. Bush, we'd all be talking about what did he know and when did he know it.
Are you saying you think Barack Obama is somehow involved in a fraudulent way?
What I'm saying is I want consistency. I'm saying if this were a Republican, Larry, the mantra with Bush coming in was he stole the election, he's from some Bible Belt state, he is from a state that is interested in the death penalty, he's an oil man, he's an oil man, and Obama's mantra is he's a prince. He's Camelot number 2. He's above politics.
Why do you resent that? You have someone
all I want
elected
you?
This historic for you? Aren't you thrilled?
All I want is... Larry, I am a Republican.
I'm thrilled
that we're in a country where somebody can be elected based upon the content of their character rather than the color of their skin. However, I want consistency in the media. I don't expect fairness anymore. I just want consistency.
Clarence Page, you think this is a plot only because it would be bigger if he were Republican?
Well, I'm sure Republicans are going to make hay out of this. They've had a lot of bad news lately. This has put more smile on Republican faces than anybody since the Jeremiah Wright videos. But I think about back in Chicago, you know, where people, we're long experienced in having scandalous headlines and all. This one is particularly deplorable. People are just so bummed out that a few weeks after the glorious spectacle we saw in Grant Park and people dancing in the streets all around the world, suddenly that spirit seems to be scuttled by not just what appears to be a sleazy scandal, but also what appears to be an amateurish and slightly somewhat bent governor. I mean, the kind of dialogue we see here sounds like something out of a bad gangster play. And I think, Jesse Jackson Jr. does need to answer questions because all we've heard is the Blagojevich ramblings on the overheard dialogues here. So I think,
James,
there's got to be another side of the story.
I don't know what planet I'm living on. I can't imagine this thing getting any more coverage than it's getting. I mean, this is the third time I've been on CNN today.
Larry wants him to blame Obama, I think.
Tomorrow, Mr. Elders, I don't know how to tell you this, but I think he's going to get about 70,000 questions tomorrow morning at his press conference. It's not like James, people are not asking questions here.
James, it's not about blaming the president. Right.
Clarence just now said we're used to this in Chicago. I just read a Time magazine article about a month ago that talked about how McCain did an ad where he tried to tie Obama to Chicago-style corruption. And the article said, well, that's old school. We're not like that anymore. Chicago's not like that anymore. They quoted a political scientist saying we're not like that anymore. The whole mantra of Barack Obama is a new guy, above politics. He's not a machine guy anymore.
Are you saying he's tied to this?
The Red Sea parted. He rolled right through. He's a politician.
Are you saying, Larry, Obama is tied to this scandal?
I am saying Obama ran the first time, Larry, by getting everybody kicked off the ballot, and he ran unopposed. I am saying that he got a lot of campaign contributions from developers who later on developed housing that has been condemned. Okay. He is a politician, a Chicago politician. Right.
Good, bad, indifferent.
Don't put him on Mount Rushmore yet.
The last I checked, Lincoln was a politician, and he's on Mount Rushmore. We'll be right back after this. Touché. Clarence Page, here's a little of what Jesse Jackson Jr., a staunch supporter of Obama, said today. Watch.
I reject and denounce pay-to-play politics and have no involvement whatsoever in any wrongdoing. I did not initiate or authorize anyone at any time to promise anything to Governor Blagojevich on my behalf. I never sent a message or an emissary to the governor to make an offer, to plead my case, or to propose a deal about a U.S. Senate seat, period.
Clarence, why was number five singled out at all?
Well, because there was the allegation. Well, you look at the transcription of the tape. Look at U.S. Attorney Fitzgerald's criminal complaint, and you see that Blagojevich was cheering the fact that he says the Senate candidate number five was offering $500,000 or $1 million in exchange for being appointed the new senator, and that and he also used the term pay for play, which was like just a bold assertion by Blagojevich. So, that some criminal activity was taking place here.
So James, is Jesse Jackson lying? I mean, what if he was number five and Fitzgerald was saying this is what number five was talking about?
Well, something ain't right. Right. This is what a quote emissary of number, and this is what Blagojevich said, that somebody from Blagojevich is not the most credible person in the world. I mean, let's be clear here. Right. Just because Rod Blagojevich said something, that don't mean it is true. And my point is that I'm willing to give Congressman Jackson every benefit of the doubt, and everything that he's saying is true. I just think he's going to have a hard time in the future maintaining the posture that he's not going to comment on this or ask any questions. I agree that it's very legitimate of the press to ask questions about this, and he's elected by people of his congressional district, and at a point, and relatively soon, he's going to have to come forward and tell people more.
Larry, where do you think it's all going?
That's a good question. We don't know. One of the questions I have is, why was the investigation stopped? If, in fact, Senator Number 5 was apparently, according to Blagojevich anyway, interested in a pay or play, why not let it go and see how far up it goes? Again, I think these are the kinds of questions that would be asked if we were talking about Republicans here. Why did it stop right now? And again, what did the guy at the top know? When did he know it? Especially when you've got a campaign chief of staff saying that Barack Obama helped to get this guy elected.
Don't all Democratic candidates help other Democratic candidates?
They certainly do, Larry, and therefore you would think that the president-elect would have a role in determining who his successor would be. I know that I would think that Barack Obama would want to know who his successor is going to be and try to influence it, but he said he hadn't had a conversation with him. What is that? Does that pass the smell test?
Then you don't believe him.
Does it pass the smell test?
Clarence,
do you believe it?
Clarence?
Larry?
Well, first
you
of all,
Obama
the question.
Was involved.
Yeah. Well, first of all, he asked the question, why was the investigation stopped? It hasn't stopped. U.S. Attorney Fitzgerald indicated that he decided to arrest Blagojevich now because he was worried that Blagojevich was going to go ahead and appoint a new senator, and then you would have a senator with what he felt was a tainted governor appointing him. But the investigation is going on. Fitzgerald has invited everybody who has information to come forward now. And we know from experience that Fitzgerald is a very, very thorough U.S. attorney. This investigation will go on.
But he went public with it, Clarence. Yes. He went public with it. And when you go public, you change everybody's behavior.
Yeah, but he's still a good prosecutor, you know. And you're a lawyer. You know that it makes the prosecution more difficult. But he wouldn't have gone public unless he felt he still had a case.
Can I make a point here? I absolutely believed the president-elect when he said he never talked to the governor about this. And the proof, by the way, Larry, the proof's in the pudding. All these conversations are taped. So if he had a conversation and said that he didn't, it would be something that Barack Obama is clearly not, and that would be stupid. He's a very bright man, and I absolutely believe him when he said he never had a conversation with Blagojevich about it.
I'd like to give him the benefit of the doubt as well, James, but isn't it interesting you've got two top campaign aides who make statements, and then all of a sudden they got to take them back? You guys would be yelling and screaming about this president-elect can't even control his own staff.
Our investigation's not over either, but there is a point to be made here for the...
Let me
look in the camera and say, you said you didn't believe the president-elect. I absolutely believe him.
I said I give him the benefit of the doubt.
The proof is in the pudding. All of these were taped, and everybody knows they were not close.
We're going to have all three of you back because this is not dull. Back in 60 seconds with...